interview on the person of Reverend Dr. Simeon Oka, the presiding bishop of Flock of Christ Mission. We'd like to ask us a few questions to know how much of the person you know about the person of Reverend Dr. Simeon Oka. The first question, sir, is, may we know you, sir?
I am Pastor Augustus Owuraigbo. I was General Overseer of the United Believers Mission, but I've handed over my office as the General Overseer. I have retired.
That's lovely. Thank you, sir. Yes. Please, sir, may we know your relationship with Bishop Simeon Oka and how long have you known him, sir?
Reverend Dr. Bishop Simeon Oka. Has been a group mate, let me say, who was young, following us, playing together, until I married the senior sister. So the relationship became very close. After marrying the senior sister, I became like a junior brother to me.
Thank you very much, sir. When did you first know that Reverend Dr. Simeon Oka had the anointing to do the work of God?
When God called us in the 70s, around 76, 78, like that, and the Holy Ghost came, really. It's something we never experienced before and we're not taught. So you hardly know what was happening, as if it's a revolution, a change of life. And our attitude, our preaching, our singing, our prayers changed. And this brought problem to the Soko area where I was born. But we were going out for evangelism nearly every month. No month expired that we did not go on evangelism. And this group of people, they were calling no less the Soko people. You know, when we close in the morning, we lay hands. Everybody is sick, and there were healings. So, Bishop Simeon Oka, very close to me, began to examine what was happening. And then he was attending Jesus Revolutionary Church of God here in Warri, you know. So he saw that there was quite something miraculous that happened. And when we talk about the Holy Spirit, anointing of the Holy Spirit, the power of God in our time, in our generation, something touched him. In their church, there was a young man in that church, which I will tell you, who was the pastor, one Dixon, you know, was prophesying quite all right that they had the Holy Spirit. So Simeon, with seven of them, they left the church and came to my house at Iri. Peter Ibe Gerrard, still now, still there. And Christopher, I would say, and you know, most of them. Seven of them came to Iri. And why are you here? With all seriousness, all amount of seriousness, that, look, this Holy Spirit, we have come, we must get the Holy Spirit. We want to receive the Holy Spirit. So it amazed me, for young men, left their work and they came that, Daddy, we want to receive the Holy Spirit. In that place, at the ring. So the house I was living, the part uncompleted. They have done the roofing, everything, plastering, but people have not packed. So I gave them a room. Put mats on the ground. And they were serious. Mats on the ground. And locked the door. I said, if you want the Holy Spirit, Bible says, whatever we desire, he gives. And if we know how to give good things to our people, what of those who ask for the Holy Spirit? So you are asking for the Holy Spirit, God is going to give it to you. And that time, God was really moving all around the world. You hear of Osborne and Robert, Billy Graham, and all that. And then he came to Nigeria, you know. So Osborne sent some people living here to come and meet us. I was among myself and Idausa and a group of them. He assembled all of us in Benin to form the Church of God Mission when the Holy Spirit was moving terribly. So this time Simeon and seven of them came. And I invited some of our boys who know how to pray, who were really filled with anointing in the house. First day, the young one went away, left them. They were crying, say, God, you don't give us, take away our life. We are not going home without receiving the anointing of the Holy Spirit. And I think, was it on the 4th or the 5th day, the Holy Spirit came on senior, powerfully on the ground, speaking in tongues and wonderful. Even yourself, you wouldn't know what, say, what is, because you cannot, you don't see Holy Spirit, but you see the manifestation. That was how Simeon became anointed with the Holy Spirit, and a few others too.
Wow, that's a very great experience.
Yes.
So, Daddy, how well have you tracked his life ever since he received the Holy Spirit? And how well have you seen the manifestation of the Holy Spirit?
No, immediately the Holy Ghost came on Simeon. You know, he became another person. And he became to feed on the word of God. You know, the church where they were, this Jesus Revolution. I told you the young man there was their pastor. Can prophesy, can tell all your names, can tell what you are wearing, he can prophesy what is going to happen tomorrow. God spoke to Simeon. Tell this man to take you to his house. That is using 6 or 7 books of Moses. Under his pillow. This young man is using me and it's not joke. Young man trembled. He said, God said, he was not the part, he is with all under him. He took him to his house. Said, open that place. God said, you have 6 or 7 books of Moses. You won't become afraid. Then I begin to see, like the question asked me, a rich man in town here. I don't want to mention them. God will tell them that this man I would have mentioned, go to his, tell him he is not serving me. By the left side of his bed, there's a juju his house. I don't want to mention them more. So the manifestation came where Simeon began to be used by the Holy Spirit in diverse methods. And immediately groups, your youth followed him. And he started evangelism, going from place to place. So the evidence became so clear. You don't need to doubt. You don't need to question.
Thank you, Daddy. So can you say that over the years, with the infilling of the Holy Spirit and the significance of his ministry going for evangelism, the Pentecostal Fellowship of Nigeria, we've come to understand that Bishop Simeon Oka has held several positions. Will you say he has displayed exemplary leadership all along?
Well, in the first place, I have not been a member of the inner caucus of the Pentecostal Fellowship. The group with which I belong, which we call United Believers Mission, we believe in Pentecostalism. We are a part of the Pentecostal system, but I have not been appointed or I have not got very near to their inner caucus. But I know that from time to time, Simeon has been a member of the inner caucus. They meet from time to time in Lagos, with Adeboye, with all these people, all the big men is there too. There's nothing that they have done that Simeon is absent. And I know Simeon has seen the vice president of this country. And I know Simeon, you know, he has been the provincial, what do we call him? The South-South, yes, president, which is a high office. Apart from that, you become the president of this, something. So he are taking high positions. And before people put somebody there, they must have known him to be special. Or, you know, he must be special, he must be, you know, up to. So I know him to be that is somebody that everybody knows. He's like a white cat. You don't hide in darkness. A bushy cat, white. So he's always picked up and he's very vocal. And he's always to the word of God. So he doesn't. Let me tell you one thing that Simeon, I won't forget, lest I forget. You know, about 6 years or 5 years, not so much. Simon started talking about this corruption. To me, I didn't understand it. He was preaching that the only thing killing this country is corruption. People didn't know what corruption was that time, you know. But he was the first person. He said, "What is killing the country's culture?" And he was saying that number one, they are the police, that they are corrupt. He said, he goes to America and this everywhere. If the police are not corrupt, this country will not be corrupt. So I remember when I was traveling to Isoko, you know, this glass factory, there's another road coming from this side that jumps there, police were there. So I was passing and they stopped me and they questioned me, "Are you Bishop Oka?" I said, what is happening? "I'm not Bishop Oka." I said, "Because Bishop Oka, we're waiting for him. He's talking, saying that we police, we are corrupt." I said, "But he has not said nothing wrong." That's to tell you that the man had impact, and having impact the situation of this country, and he's bold to say them out.
Thank you, Daddy. Apart from his impact on this nation, Nigeria, and other areas, can you say that, in your own estimation, Bishop Simeon Oka has contributed to upholding the work of God and preparing people for heaven?
Definitely so. When God called me, Simeon followed me, we went to Lagos. The church we had in Lagos was there when we crammed the pulpit together to preach in Lagos. He was there. He didn't belong to his own church that time, following me. We went to River State, one Agbere. You know, Simeon was there. But God spoke to him that he should go to the screen. That's the language. I don't forget. That he should go to the screen. He is going to use it. So he didn't waste time. He went to Benin and registered and he started preaching on the television. There people begin to know him immediately, vibrating. And through him, mighty men of God were led to God, to the kingdom. I cannot forget Edukore and what do we call him, Moshe's wife, the white man, they were all following, and Edukore, Moshe, all those people, they were following, they were there. He brought a lot of rich men poor to the name of kingdom, to the kingdom, and God used it to establish so many churches all over this nation. What else can God use? In Lagos, you got his church there. In Abuja, you have his churches there. In Benin, you have his churches there. Mention them. In the River State. So how else can God use a man? He has brought the youth, he has brought, the women, the men to God. And churches everywhere. Many of the pastors you see today, they are under the senior local. Some are broken away to form their church. That's the will of the Lord. We cannot stay in one place. I don't think he argues about that. We laugh and we rejoice. Because when people gather together, God diffuses them by giving them different languages that get scattered. If we all gather in one place, well, who will be in Abuja? Who will be in this? So sometimes he allows things to happen so that Mr. Agol forms his own. He moves that way, we move that way. Then the thing scatters. So many of the young pastors you see today, they are the briefs of Simeon.
Thank you very much, Daddy. In Flock of Christ Mission, Bishop Simeon Oka has been able to raise a venue where the sick comes. It's known as Flock Medical Center, and also we have a school. In what other areas have you seen the ministry of Simeon Oka imparting and adding value to the lives of people?
He has a Bible school, he has a secondary school, and a primary school. And like what you rightly said, I remember when the mother died, the crowd was so much. And he came with a team of doctors and nurses established on the field. Come opened, no chance. The people who came for burial, those who are sick, we attended to. You know, attended to. That's a very, very big challenge. And like we rightly said, he has a the hospital where people are attended to. Sometimes they declare something free, we're going to be treated, we're going to be cared for. And I cannot say exactly, but I know that Simeon has given many scholarship. Many students, boys and girls, scholarship. You know, many and daughters. There was a time Simeon organized, I don't know what they call it, whether feeding something, don't know the name. Feed the nation. And I hear and I saw women with their basket, they come to collect food. People were excited and happy. You know, not members of the church alone, but all over the place here in the Nere, in the Wari, you hear that Bishop Oka, there is food. And they go there and collect food and they eat and they rejoice and they go to church and they serve God. What else can a man do? To the society he belongs.
Thank you, Daddy. Flock of Christ Mission is approaching her 40th since it's been founded by the bishop. We want to know, where do you see the finger of God taking the ministry of Flock of Christ Mission under the leadership of Bishop Simeon Oka?
The Bible says, go into the world and preach the gospel. Yeah. I've told you how fire has gone in the country. He has to go inside the world now. That's where he should be taken to. Last month, my church were in Monrovia. Cost us millions to establish because we must live here. God said, go into the world. Let it cost you money, cost you time. So what is left now for Simeon Oka, as far as I know him, is going to the world. I have not said, He's gone to so many places in America, in England, and so many places to preach in the churches. But that is not all. He has to go and preach the gospel like every other person, establish churches where he can for people to worship and go to heaven. That is where God wants to take them to.
On the areas of youth development,
okay,
would you say Bishop Simeon Oka is replicating himself for the younger generations to follow the path in which he followed and God has brought him to this level?
Yes. You know, Simeon is a man of wisdom. Thank God I've been to his church, I am always there, and he has a place they call Wisdom Room. That's to show that the man is wisdom himself. It's wisdom himself. And because of that, he has places for gymnastics. Gymnastics where young ones, you know, learn exercises so that they can. He has a swimming pool. First person to be in a swimming pool in this area, as far as I know. He was the first person to establish a swimming pool, as far as I know. For the youths and the young men to come together and learn how to swim, games, and so on, so that, you know, it's only somebody alive that can work for God. Sick men do not work for God. Let me tell you one thing. If you are sick today, you don't clap heart in the church. Holy Ghost will leave you to look for a man who is healthy. He uses him until you are well, he comes back.
Daddy, for the last one, sir, is there any message you want to share to the members of the church that is Flock of Christ Mission as a body?
Yes.
Is there any message you want to share to the Flock of Christ Mission members as pertaining to their leader, Bishop Simeon Oka? What is your advice to them?
I would share to them that they are lucky to have a man in person of Simeon Oka. Let them be careful and let them stand behind him. Let them obey him. Let them follow his instructions. I tell my church, we are running lane 5. We don't chop another lane. And that lane is JESUS. Run it to the end, there will be result. So let them follow the lane Simeon is following. And they will run it to the end. There is somebody, when you run relay, you give to this. People at the end will choose first, second, third, last. Not they all who call Lord, Lord, we inherit the kingdom. Not everybody who call Lord, Lord, we inherit the kingdom, but they that do the will of God. So Simeon is out to do the will of God. Let Flock of Christ Mission follow him in areas of evangelism, areas of doing good, humanity, whatever. They will meet with the Lord on the last day, because that's our ultimate. Our ultimate is not forming a church. We are not political parties. I tell the church, we are not political parties. Neither are we society. We are a church, body of Christ. So our ultimate is to see Jesus after we left this world. So let them follow this Simeon. They will see Christ.
And finally, what is your message to the person of Bishop Simeon Oka? If he is sitting right here, what would be your message to him, sir?
I will tell him that, my dear son in the Lord, he's a big son and a big man of God all over this country. I will tell him to continue with the mode of life he has, caring for the poor, preaching the gospel, loving the people. Don't bring politics to the church. Don't bring politics to the church. The church is not a political arena. Whoever is a leader, Bible says, pray for your leaders. Pray for him, no matter what he is. Your duty is to pray for the leader. It's not your enemy. It's not your enemy at all. If he's doing wrong, you cannot correct him. God will correct him. Because there is no authority set. Bible says that is not given by God. All authorities are established by God. So whoever is authority, if he's not doing well, after his time, you will see God removing him, putting another person, removing him. It has been from origins. I'll tell Simeon to be careful about politics so that the devil doesn't lure him to preaching politics in the church, to establishing himself as a member of a political party. No, God has given him, we cannot serve mammon and God. He has given you a ministry. If you wanted to be a good politician, you will not come to the church. You be a politician, become governor, a senator, this. Okay, that is good. But God wants you to be at the helm of his children. So take care of the flock that God gave to you. And forget about what politics. I'm not saying hate government. I'm not saying that you are out. We have the voice to tell the world what is wrong and pray for them. That's what I will tell you.